Report finds climate crisis could displace over 1 billion persons by 2050. Australia-headquartered global think tank, the Institute for Economics and Peace, gathered data from international organizations, including the United Nations, to calculate 157 nations' preparedness for ecological threats from population growth, water stress, food insecurity, droughts, floods, cyclones, and rising temperatures and sea levels. The paper states that approximately 1.2 billion people across 31 countries are the most vulnerable and could be uprooted by the impact of these hazards within 30 years. Water, food shortages, and increased exposure to natural disasters may drive mass migrations to developed countries, as well as create tremendous social and political conflict, thus forming serious challenges to global peace and development. Thank you, Institute for Economics and Peace Researchers, for this important eye-opening information. In God's protective gaze, may all states now swiftly enact vegan law for a harmonious and climate-stable world.
Greece sends ships to shelter refugees after campfire. The Greek government and a private company sent vessels to help provide temporary housing to 2,000 of the 13,000 refugees living in a government-run camp on the Greek island of Lesbos that burned down in September 2020. Authorities have also put up a short-term tent facility to accommodate 9,500 people, and approximately 400 children and teenagers from the camp were flown to mainland Greece. Following the fire, France agreed to take in 400 unaccompanied minors and Germany a Shining World Leadership Award for Compassion and Shining World Caring Leadership Award laureate announced it would be accepting 1,500 refugees from Greece. Our appreciation, Greece, Germany, and France, for acting quickly to help our sisters and brothers in their time of dire need. We pray that all refugees will soon find stable homes and employment to live comfortably in the Providence's care.
Brazilian company develops pay-as-you-go solar fridge for Africa. Brazilian enterprise Youma has created a 100-liter capacity fridge for off-grid areas to keep food fresh longer and safely store medications. Consuming 25% of the power of a conventional refrigerator, the battery keeps the appliance running for a day and a half without sunlight. The package includes the installation of a rooftop solar panel, LED and strip lights, and phone charging cables, with a $1 to $1.50 daily fee paid by one's mobile phone. Customers own the entire system after around 2 years of payments. Currently, the refrigerators are available in Uganda and Kenya. Way to go, Youma, for your life-improving technology to help African people and businesses without electricity to have a cold storage option. May smart solutions like your solar fridge soon become widespread in developing areas as we tread more lightly on our planet in heaven's grace.
Student creates robotic guide dog for the visually impaired. Anthony Camus of Loughborough University in England, UK, has designed a handheld prototype named Thea that uses a special control moment gyroscope to gently lead one by a pulling sensation. This replicates a guide dog's leash pull towards the direction of the desired destination. It uses real-time data to calculate the best path to avoid unfavorable weather, traffic, and pedestrians. Besides providing guidance in large indoor areas and outdoors, Thea can assist the non-sighted with negotiating stairs and elevators. When perfected, Thea will offer an alternative to people without guide dogs, and Mr. Camus hopes the device will enable users to travel more safely and quickly. Kind-hearted Anthony Camus, we applaud your innovative project to improve the lives of the visually impaired worldwide. May Thea soon be ready to help people accomplish their daily activities with more ease and celestial delight.
Couple shares the joy of art during travels. Cora Rose, a 33-year-old teacher and singer-songwriter from Wisconsin, United States, and her partner, 39-year-old photographer, painter, and musician Jose Luis Vilches from Nicaragua, converted an old school bus into a mobile art studio and provide free music and art education to underprivileged communities. Calling their project Art We There Yet, in the last 4 years they have traveled over 48,000 kilometers across North, Central, and South America. One of their most memorable times was holding a children's art workshop at a migrant camp on the US-Mexico border. Ms. Rose says the youngsters there derived immense happiness from being creative and that exploring art provided them the opportunity to work through complex emotions. Our jubilant appreciation for your uplifting endeavor, Jose Luis Vilches and Cora Rose. May God bless you immensely as you continue to spread your inspirational art and music in your journeys.
Beyond Meat to begin production in China. United States-headquartered plant protein manufacturer Beyond Meat has announced a partnership with Jiaxing Economic and Technological Development Zone to design and create two state-of-the-art plants near Shanghai, China. In a statement, Beyond Meat founder and CEO Ethan Brown said one of the sites would be one of the world's largest plant-based meat manufacturing facilities. A market leader, Beyond Meat's investment makes it the first multinational company dedicated to meat analogs to open a production enterprise in China. The factory should begin manufacturing vegan beef, pork, and chicken in a matter of months, achieving full-scale operations in early 2021. Congratulations, Beyond Meat and Jiaxing Economic and Technological Development Zone on your venture. Your compassionate mission of spreading delicious and healthy plant-based eating is creating a happier future for humans and animals alike in heaven's radiance.
Russian woman dedicates life to homeless animals. Aside from two human roommates, animal rescuer Anastasia Pomorina currently shares her two-room apartment in Moscow with 15 dogs and 13 cats she saved. Ms. Pomorina's five other rescued canines are staying at her mother's house. Besides being part of the animal rescue network Fluffy Help that has to date saved approximately 300 lives, Ms. Pomorina also provides food and arranges sterilization for animals living on the streets. Furthermore, the online project she co-founded, Happiness Delivered Home, has helped many animals find forever homes. Ms. Pomorina, who spends over $700 a month on canines and felines, hopes to have a small countryside bed and breakfast property one day where her four-legged friends can roam. Our gratitude, Anastasia Pomorina, for your enormous generosity and work with Fluffy Help and Happiness Delivered Home. May we always provide loving assistance to our precious animal darlings in the Divine's abiding care.